the Indian Institute of Space Science and Technology, located on the foothills of Sahyadri, in Asia's first space institute, set up, supported, and funded by the Department of Space. It was set up with the noble mandate of encouraging, equipping, and engaging young brilliant minds in the Indian space program.
Indian Space Research Organization and Department of Space established the Indian Institute of Space Science and Technology in 2007. It aims to cover space technology, space sciences, and space applications. The aim is to create a world-class institution of teaching, research, and developing new technologies for the new space activities and for the new space generation.
Indian Space Research Organization has made its mark as the country's leading institute involved in developing and building space technology and its application to various national tasks. ISRO has successfully operationalized three major satellite systems: the Indian National Satellites, INSAT, Indian Remote Sensing, IRS, and the Indian Regional Navigation Satellite Services, or the NAVIC. ISRO has operationalized two satellite launch vehicles, Polar Satellite Launch Vehicle, PSLV, and Geostationary Satellite Launch Vehicle, GSLV. IIST provides the necessary education and passage to ISRO to the aspiring space scientists. Recognized by UGC as deemed university, IIST offers a complete range of undergraduate, postgraduate, doctoral and postdoctoral programs with specific focus on space science, technology and applications. Situated in the thickly wooded campus in Valiamala, some 25 kilometers away from Thiruvananthapuram, IIST has an undergraduate program in aerospace engineering and avionics engineering, while a dual degree program in engineering physics.
This is a five-year program. In the first 3 years, it will be largely covering the BTEC engineering physics portion, which is largely with physics, mathematics, and electronics and communication engineering. At the end of the third year, you branch out into one of the master's programs of your choice. It could be in optical engineering, solid state physics, atmospheric, earth and atmospheric sciences, or it could be astronomy and astrophysics. So primarily we are targeting the R&D industry to supply scientific manpower. Also, if a student is keen to pursue research in science, pure science, I think this will be an excellent program.
At the BTEC level, we teach basic courses like solid mechanics, fluid mechanics, thermodynamics, and heat transfer. We also offer applied courses like aerodynamics, flight mechanics, propulsion, aerospace structures, and orbital mechanics.
Our flagship program is BTEC in avionics. It covers topics including electrical engineering, electrical and electronics engineering, instrumentation and control, electronics and communication engineering, and computer science engineering.
Along with the generic requirements of engineering and science courses, the students of all three streams will also learn in depth about the specific areas needed for ISRO programs. The courses are offered through the seven major departments under various streams like aerospace, avionics, chemistry, earth and space science, humanities, mathematics, and physics. Currently, IIST has 568 BTEC students in all the three branches of the institute. At the undergraduate level, every year, 60 students are admitted each to aerospace and avionics engineering branches, and 20 students are admitted in the engineering physics branch.
The selection to IIST undergraduate admission program is essentially based on the candidate's performance in the All India Joint Entrance Examination, JEE Advanced. And we have also specified a minimum criteria, a minimum marks to be secured in the JEE Advanced. Over the years, we are very much happy and satisfied of the quality of the candidates selected, their state-wise distribution over India, and the gender ratio.
Whoever comes to IIST, the undergraduate students, they are very lucky in the sense the all expenses being taken care of by the government of India.
IIST has an assistantship package of 48,400 rupees for all students once in a semester to meet the cost of education. The tuition, lodging and boarding of the students is free. In addition, they receive a book grant of rupees 3,000 to purchase books of their subject. To be eligible for this, the student has to score GPA equal to or more than 7.5 points per semester. In case a student fails to score the requisite GPA, then his or her assistantship will be discontinued for the next semester. The assistantship is restarted if the student once again scores 7.5 GPA on the scale of 10. The admission to the PG programs are open both to scientist engineers of ISRO and non-ISRO candidates. The admission for PhD against open advertisement is available to the public, while options for PhD admissions are also available to scientist engineers from DOS, ISRO and in-house faculty.
I registered my PhD, part-time PhD under the guidance of Professor V. Radhakrishnan. The topic was basically in manufacturing technology. It was in investigations on elasto abrasive finishing of surfaces. We got a lot of support from IASU, LPSE, where I could use many of the facilities such as inspection, quality control facilities and all this.
Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam was the founding chancellor of the university. Dr. UR Rao is the present chancellor of the university.
You must liberate yourself through new ideas, discoveries and inventions to create a prosperous, just and equitable society. If only you can dare to dream and back up your dreams with dedicated hard work and firm commitment, you will no doubt succeed in enabling this nation as an inheritor of proud civilization to once again occupy its rightful place in the community of nations.
Shri A.S. Kiran Kumar, Secretary DOS and Chairman ISRO, is the chairman of the university.
The students who have come out of this university, come out of this institution, have a challenge cut out for them, where during their work, they need to bring in new innovations and bring in new technologies and make space travel easier and accessible, not only for societal benefit, but also for ensuring that we can travel to outer space and maybe make colonies in the future there. So it's a very challenging time, where the environment within the country and globally is seeing a sea change, and this gives us tremendous opportunities to look into the future and to look at how we can make things happen differently.
The institute started with the undergraduate BTech program. Later on, MTech and MS were added, and subsequently, we developed a PhD program also. With 100 faculty, and around 700 students, we have a very good student to teacher ratio.
We have faculty with at various stages in their career. We have very senior faculty who have had a significant amount of experience in top institutes outside, and they naturally are experts in their areas, and they are recognized nationally or internationally. And we have a large number of young faculty who are very highly qualified. I would say would be as good as most of the faculty in the top institutes in the country, like IITs and NITs, because all of them have PhD and they are doing research.
With a good mix of practicals, tutorials and lectures, right from the undergraduate level, the curriculum is designed to give the students a flavor of research, as IIST believes in creating opportunities for innovations in space science and technology. Laboratory infrastructure is a key component of the learning environment at IIST. Flight Mechanics Lab is designed to reinforce the concepts through practical hands-on experience.
We also have simulators, so in which we teach them the controls. They go through a complete sequence of taxiing, takeoff, cruise, that is climb, cruise, turning, landing. On simulator, they crash 100 times, nothing happens. But one thing they realize out of that is flight is not an easy thing.
Under the Center of Excellence plan, each department has established laboratories for general and advanced research like the Advanced Propulsion and Laser Diagnostics Labs.
Information that you collect based on this laser diagnostics application will reveal enormous amount of insight into the physical and chemical processes that are happening. And from there, one could understand these phenomena better, and that could lead to efficient design, and that could significantly advance the technological capability of the aerospace industry.
The Virtual Reality Lab.
First phase, we have developed desktop virtual reality lab, and we have a very good high-end workstation and 3D monitors. And then we have also gadgets which we can, like data gloves and stereo vision camera. And then we have sophisticated software which will allow you to create visualization, 3D visualization, and you can implement your ideas.
And the Climate Observatory at Punmudi.
Basically, one of the objectives of our IIST is to probe Earth's atmosphere, and clouds plays a bigger role in Earth's atmosphere. So we wanted to understand, and we wanted to measure cloud by cloud, understand the basic physics behind its formation, and if the pollution is there, and if there is no pollution, how the pollution plays a role in the formation of clouds and its radiative impacts. We wanted to understand that.
So IIST, being deemed to be a university, it takes up research work in the areas of fundamental research, like basic sciences, say physics, chemistry, mathematics, humanities, aerospace, earth and space science, and avionics. Various topics in these disciplines are taken up, and this wherever it's going to be applicable in the industry, such research topics are being taken and encouraged to do collaborative research with.
IIST and ISRO are working on many collaborative projects which provide opportunities to all students to work directly in the relevant ISRO's research requirements and contribute significantly to it. IIST encourages its students to undertake projects and internship with ISRO and DOS under the guidance of IIST faculty and ISRO scientists. The objective is to provide the students with knowledge and hands-on experience to work as a team in the design, development and building of space systems.
Currently we have MTech internship programs in the summer for 2 months from May to June. And in certain MTech programs, this could extend up to 6 months or as long as even 1 year, wherein students have been allowed to do their MTech project work with joint guidance by faculty from IIST.
To provide for exchange of students, initiate joint research on mutually accepted areas and provide fellowships for training and research, IIST has signed MOUs with California Institute of Technology, USA, and University Space Research Association, USA.
Space is an international endeavor. IIST has extremely good international linkages and collaboration. It includes the opportunity of a BTech topper of the aerospace and avionics engineer who would be able to go to Caltech to do a MS sponsored by the ISRO and the IIST. In addition, we will be developing CubeSats in collaboration with the University of Colorado, with the Caltech, and under discussion are a large number of collaboration with many foreign universities.
The output of many of these researches and projects are intellectual property, which if protected can be commercialized. So this is one of the major activities that we have. We protect the intellectual property coming out of IIST. These are typically patented.
High-end workstations are installed with several advanced engineering, and scientific software. A programming lab has also been set up for undergraduate students. An internet lab for the use of undergraduate students is also provided. The students of 2008-2010 batches had designed and realized a sounding rocket, Project Vyom, with extensive support of experts from VSSC, ISRO, and supervision of faculty at IIST.
So the experience which they gained out of Vyom 1, now they are using for Vyom 2. For Vyom 2, we have even more challenging target. We are planning to take 15 kg of payload to something like 70 kilometers altitude. So it's really challenging because we want to still retain a single stage rocket.
Okay, the main objective of this nanosatellite program is to train our students in developing and understanding satellite technology.
The students have conceived a three-axis stabilized nanosatellite of mass less than 2 kilograms to be launched as a piggyback payload in PSLV.
We have developed prototypes of the payload itself, that is the high energy particle detector, the onboard computer, and then the electrical power systems.
Along with the academics content that we teach, we also give an exposure to the students about the need of the society.
Hence, every year we take them to one of the tribal settlements of Kerala.
The students are trying to make a very simple technology which they can deliver to these people, and through that they can better their life in the region.
The main outreach program of IIST is IIST at Schools, which we normally conduct for the school students of Kerala. It is a 3-day residential program where we bring the school students to IIST, and where they are introduced to the basics behind or the mysteries behind great technological achievements.
The program primarily aims to catch the students, brilliant school students in their young age, and explore or expose the world of science and technology towards them.
The institute has adopted credit system, and the total number of grades for BTech course is around 165 credits.
Mostly we have 3 credit courses. 3 credit essentially means you have 3 contact lectures per week. We also have a few first year courses which have 4 credits, and sometimes you can have 3 credits of lecture plus 1 credit of tutorial, like 3-1-0 we call LTP, lecture, tutorial and practical.
On completion of course in 4 years of admission, a student shall be considered for absorption in ISRO establishments.
The BTech graduates who score more than 7.5 CGPA and depends upon the number of vacancies notified by ISRO, have an opportunity to join ISRO directly.
I'm working in a group called CSTDG, which is Cryostructures and Tankages Design Group. It deals with design of cryostructures. So these are structures which deal temperatures of minus 250 degrees centigrade. So it's pretty challenging design them, and that is what my group deals with.
I'm working in INSS series of satellites, the constellation which we are sending to space for having our own global positioning system. So I am working as a thermal engineer there, and I am looking after the implementation part of heaters, thermistors and other thermal elements in that.
The role of placement cell is to assist all the students who registered with placement cell in getting the desired opportunity in various sectors, including R&D firms, corporate sector, software firms. Even we invite students to start their own business as well as the startups. Moreover, the placement cell assists the student in developing the interpersonal skill, software skills and the technical skills which is required by industries.
IIST always encourages students to organize and participate in events and festivals. Consensia, the Astronomy and Technology Festival, centered on the concepts of imagination and creativity, is entirely managed by IIST students. number of interesting events, quizzes, workshops, lectures, demonstrations, paper presentations, and interactive programs in the domains of space technology, astronomy, robotics, and applied sciences are organized during this festival. Students from all over the country participate in this Tech Fest, which provides an opportunity for IISTians to rub shoulders with their peers from other institutes.
The main responsibility of technical committee is to help students discover their technical ability beyond the standard syllabus and the textbooks which they spend the most of their time. Technical committee also takes care of guiding the students via various technical clubs like Aero Club and other activities where we help students develop various skills which they perhaps can use later on in their life in the industry.
Dhanak, the annual cultural festival of IIST, organized every year, is a perfect platform for projecting the cultural and literary activities of this institute.
IIST, with its vision of holistic development of students, encourages them to participate in co-curricular and extracurricular activities. The most important fest of IIST are its Culture Fest Dhanak and the Technical Fest Consentia. These are completely managed by the students with the support of faculty members. These national fests witness a get-together of more than 1,000 students from various institutions across the country.
The Institute annually celebrates Sports Day, wherein students and faculty members compete in several sporting events. The students are encouraged and supported to participate in various state and national level competitions. The library set up by IIST boasts of an excellent collection of books and electronic journals, 24/7 online and internet services, fully computerized in-house operations, and open library management software, Koha.
In addition to these, there is a textbook bank for undergraduate students, where we collected all the prominent textbooks for their academic purposes. So students can take the books at the beginning of the semester. This ensures that they get enough books at the beginning of the semester itself for that particular semester. And at the end of the semester, they have to return the book bank to library.
At the initiative of the library, a bookshop has been started in the campus for the sale of books at a discount. IIST's 13 hostel blocks for students and scholars are located in a peaceful environment with proximity to canteens, cafe, gymnasium, and the medical center. Each of these hostel blocks is designed with well-ventilated rooms on single and double occupancy basis and furnished with essentials that enable comfortable stay and study. Wi-Fi is also provided in all the hostels, enabling high-speed access to the internet, generator-backed power, and ample supply of drinking water are ensured on a 24-hour basis. Each floor has common washrooms with modern cleaning equipment and sanitation facilities. Hygiene and cleanliness of the rooms, floors, and surroundings are taken care of by routine housekeeping services. Security personnel are available for round-the-clock support in the hostels. IIST Canteen Services daily provides canteen facility to all the residential students, the faculty, and the staff. A first aid center with all facilities provides services to students and staff on all days of the week. An ambulance is stationed 24/7 for emergency purposes. A clinic has been established on the campus with sufficient medicines and equipment to take care of any medical needs. IIST has ensured emergency medical care and hospitalization for all its students by entering into a memorandum of understanding with SUT Medical College. Every student of IIST also gets a medical insurance coverage up to rupees 1 lakh which is funded from the assistantship fee granted by the Department of Space.
Here you have a full-fledged academically residential place where they're away from their homes, you know, away from their environment as such. It's in the extreme south. So we give them a series of holistic programs for their development as such.
The students can approach their faculty mentor anytime and get proper counseling and guidance on any of their personal and academic matters. The Institute has a separate women's cell to provide for counseling and guidance to women students. Ragging is strictly prohibited on IIST campus. The Institute has ensured that all its students are safe on the campus and do not face any kind of harassment from any senior student. As an academic and research university, IIST wishes to be engaged with the frontiers of knowledge, recognize the importance of providing value-based education, of making judgments about the relative importance of different subjects, and of giving equal importance to the issue of character and morality. True value of an institute lies in creating responsible and good human beings who will take on the onerous task of nation building and development.
In 10 years of its existence, due to our extremely talented faculty, very bright set of students, and a singular focus on the space program, we have established ourselves as a space university. Even in the educational sector, under the National Institutional Ranking Framework, IIST has performed very creditably compared to a large number of universities and institutions of higher learning, which are much larger and established many years ago.
The vision of IIST is to be a world-class educational and research institute, contributing significantly to space endeavors.